Good morning, everyone. I hope that you're having a wonderful day. Today, I wanted to talk about cardholders. I wanted to do a quick overview on each of them and also compare them in terms of price, wear and tear, best value, etc. So I hope that you enjoy this video. If you do, make sure and give it a thumbs up. And without further ado, let's get started, shall we? I thought we should start off with an overview of each of them, and I'm going to begin with Chanel. These are in no particular order, and I will be putting the measurements down on the frame as I'm talking about them. All right, so I do have two classic card holders from Chanel. Both of them are in the quilted caviar leather. One is in the black caviar leather with a gold hardware. The other is in the red caviar leather with a silver hardware. Now, this guy has been strassed out by a third party, and with Chanel card holders, they're available in a variety of different colors, different materials, as well as different types of hardware. But when it comes to their classics, it does have a total of 4 credit card slots. You have one in the front, you have 2 on the back, and then you also have one at the very top. And these card slots, they do have a little bit of leather, and then they go into fabric. It might be a little bit easier to see it on the red one. There we go. Actually, there, that white part, it's all fabric. And you can see it on this side as well. There we go. So again, this one was strassed out by a third party. But here is the Chanel card holder. Oops. Next is the Louis Vuitton double card holder in the Monogram Eclipse. And this is a combination of canvas and leather. It has a total of 5 credit card slots. You have 2 in the front, 2 in the back, 1 at the very top, and all of these card slots are lined in leather. And then you also have an all leather card slot on each side. So one on here and one on here. There we go. There's a side view. Next is the Saint Laurent Monogram card case. Both are in the pebbled leather. One is in the beautiful beige with the silver hardware. The other is in the black with the silver hardware. Now, these are available in a variety of different colors, either with the leather or with the hardware. And these card holders have a total of 5 credit card slots. You have 2 in the front, 2 in the back, and then you also have another one on top. And all of these are lined in leather as well. But there is a front view. There's a side view. Back view, and let me show you guys again the beige. There we go. Next is a Goyard signature card holder. This is available in a variety of different colors, and it's a combination of canvas and leather. You have a total of 5 different credit card slots. You have 2 in the front, 2 in the back, and then you also have one at the very top, and all of these card slots are lined in leather, and they do have that signature Goyard yellow. There we go. Might be a little bit easier to see. But there is the front, side view, and there we go. And last but not least, the Louis Vuitton Mon Mono card holder. Now this is available in a variety of different colors as well. It really depends on the combination that you want to go for Mon Mono, but you can also go for the classic, which pretty much looks like this, but it doesn't have the burgundy. It just has the classic brown that Louis Vuitton is known for. But as far as this card holder goes, it is a combination of canvas and leather. You have mostly canvas on the exterior, and then you have the leather on the very top. You have a total of 3 different credit card slots, one in the front, one in the back, and then one at the very top. There we go. And then again, I did have this customized, so I have my initial on there. I chose the colors burgundy and white. So there is again the front side, there is a side view of it, and the back side. Let's talk pricing, shall we? All right, so with the Saint Laurent card holder and the black pebbled leather with the silver hardware, this guy comes in at $275 here in the States. With the Louis Vuitton double card holder in the Monogram Eclipse, this guy comes in at $305. The Chanel card holder, this is in the black quilted caviar leather with the gold hardware, this is $425. However, with the Chanel card holders, they do end up varying depending on the line, depending on the detail that it has. So just keep that in mind. But as far as the classic, it is $425. The Goyard signature card holder comes in at $475 here in the States. And last but not least, the Louis Vuitton Mon Mono. This guy comes in at $320. If you do decide to go for the classic card holder without the Mon Mono, it pretty much looks like this. That guy comes in at $210 here in the States. Let's let's move on to wear and tear. So when it comes to the Goyard, I've had this card holder for about 6 or 7 months, give or take, and I've used it quite a bit, and so far so good. I really haven't had any issues with wear and tear either on the canvas or with the leather. I haven't had any issues with the chipping or any type of pop stitches or any kind of scratches either, so I think that's great. It definitely has some wonderful material, some great quality. But what I would have to mention is that usually when I end up using this card holder, I do like to double up the card slots, and I like the fact that you can't really tell that they've been stretched out too much. You can't really tell that I end up doubling them up, but I would have to mention that when I do end up doing that, it ends up getting a little bit crazy to get into this pocket here, of course. I feel like that's a given, right? Because if I end up kind of doubling up this side and this side, it's gonna be a little bit tighter to get into this top pocket there. So I just wanted to mention it just in case, but other than that, I have definitely used it quite a bit, as I mentioned previously, and it's been holding up fabulously. As far as wear and tear on the Louis Vuitton Mon Monogram, I've had this card holder for about a year, year and a half. I've used it quite a bit. I haven't babied it, and I absolutely love the colors. I went for burgundy and white, and I feel that it really ends up complementing the monogram quite nicely. Now, I have started to have some wear and tear on this corner part. I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to see it or not, but the white part has started to chip kind of by that seam, so that right there. And then on the burgundy part, it was actually a lot darker when I first got it, and now I've noticed that it's started to kind of lighten up, and you can really see, they're not like white pebbles, but like white like specks throughout it. I don't know, again, if you're gonna be able to see it or not, but it has definitely changed color. I have not been careful with this, as I mentioned previously. I just use it, I enjoy it. There is one thing that I wanted to mention. With this card holder, I really end up going for the bare essentials when it comes to my wallet, because I've noticed that when I do try to double these up, I honestly feel like it's gonna bust at the seams. Like, I feel like it's a little bit stiff. It's not as easy to retrieve the items if I end up trying to double them up. Sometimes I know, sometimes I've tried to put three in there. I don't recommend that. It has started to stretch out a little bit on the side, not as much as you would think, but again, I don't end up doubling up the cards as much with this one, just because it's a little stiff, and I honestly think that I just feel like it's just gonna rip open, you know? So I try not to overstuff it. We all know I struggle with this, all right? Don't judge me. But as far as the colors here, they have definitely started to change, and they're starting to kind of fade out a little bit. But the M so far is good. No issues on the M that I can see. There we go. Now for the Saint Laurent card holder, I've actually had the black one for 5.5, 6 years, I wanna say. And the beige one, I actually got it as a birthday present last year. But this one so far, no issues with wear and tear, no problems with color transfer either, no pop stitches. So I think that's great. And with the black one, like I said before, I've had it for quite some time. I absolutely love it. This pebble leather is fantastic. I have put this card holder through the ringer time and time and time again. And I feel like it just continues to be right on top. No issues with pop stitches. I will have to say there are some light, very, very light hairline scratches on the hardware. But other than that, it pretty much looks like the day that I got it. And I wanted to mention one other thing, that when I end up using this card holder, I have used it in my leather lined handbags. I've had so many of you guys ask me if I've had any indentations, if I've had this monogram leave any indentation in the lining. And so far I haven't experienced that. So I also wanted to say that. I do end up doubling up the cards many, many of times, and it really hasn't stretched out, which I think is wonderful. I will have to say that in the beginning, when I first got it, it was stiff. It was stiff. I mean, it has definitely loosened up, but I love the fact that it hasn't loosened up to the point where if you end up having your cards in here, either single or doubled up, that they're gonna be flying out, you know? But just keep that in mind. If you do end up going for it, don't be surprised if you kind of sit there for a little bit, and it might be fussy in the beginning to try to take them out, because this leather is like, no, I'm gonna hold on to your credit cards type of thing. But trust me, it is so, so worth it, because 5.5 years, 6 years, however long I've had this thing, it has just held up insanely, insanely well. So there we go. As far as the Louis Vuitton double card holder, this guy I've had it for about a year and a couple of months, and I have definitely put this thing through the ringer, and I think it's wonderful. It is so incredibly beautiful, but we all know I am a sucker when it comes to the monogram Eclipse, but I haven't had any issues with pop stitches. I haven't had any issues with the varnish either. It hasn't melted, because I have had some Louis Vuitton pieces that the varnish has started to melt, but so far so good. I will have to say that I definitely end up maximizing my space when it comes to this card holder, because I often double up the credit card slots. Sometimes on the top one, I end up putting 3-4 plus cash. I know, but we all know how I am. And you can definitely see that it has started to kind of stretch out a bit. And I feel like if I continuously do that, if I end up doing that time and time again, if I do end up carrying either one credit card and maybe some cash, because it's stretched out so much, I feel like it might end up falling out. So I just want to throw that out there just in case you guys do the same thing that I do. But again, I really like to maximize my space when it comes to this card holder. But here you can definitely see it a little bit better, that this top part has started to stretch out a bit, as well as these. But on the side card holders, on the side card slots, they haven't stretched out to the point where the cards are going to fly out if I end up having them, if I end up having just one, or if I end up doubling them up either. So I also wanted to let you guys know on that. And when it comes to the Chanel ones, I've had this card holder for going on 7 years, if I'm not mistaken. I believe this one is 6. Now with these, when I first got this card holder, I used it so much. I absolutely loved it, and I still love it. I think it's gorgeous, but I've noticed that as the years have gone by, I don't really use it as often as I did in the beginning. And with this one, no issues with pop stitches, no issues. I feel like it's still pretty puffy, which I think is great. I think the pebbles have definitely stood the test of time. The only thing is that I have some hairline scratches on the hardware, but I haven't experienced any type of chipping on that hardware either. Now with this one, sometimes I do end up doubling up the cards. Sometimes I end up putting 3 in there. I definitely want to maximize my space, but as you can see, it really hasn't stretched out too much. But again, this isn't a card holder that I constantly have on rotation in comparison to some of the other ones that I just showed you guys. Now with the red one, this one was actually my least used card holder. This one, I do have a pop stitch. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it or not, right up here. And then I do have some hairline scratches on the hardware. But with this one, you know, I love the red. It's the classic Chanel red, and I didn't really end up using it too much. And then I decided to get it strassed out. As many of you know, I went through Urban Bling. She did such an amazing job. These are all genuine Swarovski crystals. So in the sun, it looks insane. Insane. And I mean, I'm here for it. I'm absolutely here for it. But even though I've had it strassed out, and This has become one of my most used card holders, I haven't had any issues with any of the stones falling out. She also supplied me with some extras just in case some of them fell out. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. No issues with it falling apart. One thing that I wanted to mention as far as the card holder goes, if you do end up going for a light colored card holder, from what I have seen, most of them do end up having, I shouldn't say most of them, some of them I have noticed end up having the white fabric on the inside, and that fabric has started to change color. It is now kind of like a yellowy, eggshelly kind of tint to it. It's not as bright. It's not as stark as it once was. So I just wanted to mention that just in case, because it has definitely changed color. So there we go. I don't know if you're going to be able, there we go. You can see it a little bit better. See that, like that yellow tint to it? That's the color that it is. So it has definitely ended up changing. But besides that, and the little pop stitch, it is held up quite nicely, and I have also doubled up the cards in here, and so far so good. You can see that it has stretched out quite a bit, not to the point where your items are gonna fly out, but I just wanted to mention that just in case. On to recommendations. Let's start off with the Chanel card holder. Do I recommend it? Absolutely, I do. I think that these card holders are so incredibly beautiful. They're simple, and I mean, they're classic card holders when it comes to Chanel. And not only that, the fact that they are leather, so that way you have a little bit more play, and the material isn't as stiff either, especially as time goes by, the more and more that you use it, it'll start to relax a little bit more. But I think that they are insanely gorgeous. And let's say that you have a card holder that you don't really use too often, kind of like myself when it came to the red one, you can always choose to strass it out, kind of snazz it up a bit, add a little bit more oomph to it, if you will, like I did with this guy. And I mean, let's be honest, all right, I'm a magpie. I can't deny the shiny. I can't deny the sparkles either. So having had it strassed out definitely ended up bumping this card holder from one of my least used to one of my most used, because again, I cannot deny the sparkle. So absolutely love the classic Chanel card holder and definitely, definitely recommend it. On to the Louis Vuitton double card holder. Do I recommend it? Absolutely, I do. I think that this is a fabulous card holder. You have 5 different credit card slots, and also the fact that it is more carefree and you have this type of leather gives it a little bit more play. So again, it's not as stiff as some of the other all canvas type of card holders that they have. I think it's beautiful, and I gotta admit, I am a major, major fan of Monogram Eclipse. We all know this, so that also adds to how much I love it. But in general, I mean, the fact that it does have the 5 credit card slots that you can end up doubling up gives you, again, a little bit more play. So absolutely recommend it. On to the Mon Mono. Now, do I recommend it? I'm kind of 50-50 because, I mean, I do love the colors. I love the colors that I chose. I feel that they end up complementing the monogram quite nicely. And I also like the fact that it is custom, but kind of like what I talked about in the wear and tear, it ends up getting a little tight in here if I end up trying to double up the cards. Not only that, I feel like you're paying the extra $110 for it to be, you know, personalized, and it only has it on one side. So even though I do like the colors and the fact that you can choose your colors, I think is wonderful, but if you couldn't care less about having your initial on there or about choosing your color, then I would end up saving some money and going for the classic. If again, you just want a simple card holder. But this guy, the fact that it doesn't have as many credit card slots, it doesn't have as much play, that's kind of why I'm like 50-50 on whether or not I would recommend it. But it really depends on what it is that you want to go for. If you want something that's super simple, or if you want something that has a little bit more of a pop of color and is custom, then this would be, you know, this would be great. But again, it's a matter of personal preference. And on to the Saint Laurent card holder. Do I recommend it? Absolutely, I do. 100%. I will recommend this card holder over and over and over again. I'm sure you guys are sick and tired of me talking about this, but I think it's that fantastic. It has 5 different credit card slots. The fact that it's also an all leather card holder, not to mention the fact that you also have this incredibly, insanely durable pebbled leather, I think is fantastic. So yes, absolutely 100% recommend this card holder. And last but not least, the Goyard. Now, do I recommend this? I'm kind of 50-50 on this one as well, to be completely honest with you. And there are so many things that I appreciate from Goyard. I love their history. I also like the fact that this is a brand that you don't see as often as some of the ones that I've talked about in this video. And even though I haven't had any issues with their wear and tear thus far, either with the canvas or with the leather, I think that's great. So they do have great quality, and I am a sucker for the colors. If you couldn't tell, burgundy is definitely my jam, but I just feel that the reason why I'm kind of 50-50 is because I do think that they're a tad bit overpriced, considering that this does have canvas, and for that price point, I feel like you can end up going for a different fashion house that has all leather versus having a combination of canvas and leather. Again, I'm not trying to take anything away from it, and it really depends upon what it is that you're looking for, but I just feel that for that price tag, I would end up going for a different fashion house that has all leather that might be a lot more durable as time goes by, you know, but it's definitely all about personal preference. Now, after everything has been said and done, after everything I discussed on this video, if I was to rank these card holders in terms of best value, this this is the order that I would do it in. My number one spot, my best value, my end all be all, definitely 100% recommend the card holder, it would be the Saint Laurent. I mean, the fact that this is an all leather card holder and it has a friendly price point coming in at $275, the fact that you do have 5 credit card slots definitely makes this my number one. I think it is fantastic and that pebbled leather just wears so, so well. Next up, I would have to say is the Louis Vuitton double card holder. Again, because you're not limited to just one or two. You have 5 different credit card slots. It is also incredibly carefree and coming in at $305, I feel like this offers so, so much. There we go. My number 3 spot would be the Chanel card holder. The fact that you do have 4 credit card slots, so it's not too limiting, and this awesome, awesome leather I feel ends up wearing fabulously as time goes by. So there we go. And the fact that it is classic, the fact that it pretty much goes with everything and anything, I think is awesome as well. My number 4 spot would be the Goyard signature card holder. Just because you do have 5 different credit card slots, it's not too limiting. And even though it does have canvas, the fact that you do have these beautiful pockets that are leather lined or these slots that are leather lined, I think is wonderful. And so far the quality has been absolutely amazing. And that leaves me to my number 5 spot, the Louis Vuitton Mon Mono card holder. Now I still love this and I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world, but when it comes to card holders and being able to maximize your space and being able to carry a little bit more with you and having something that is a little bit more durable, this one definitely doesn't end up checking off all of the marks, but it is insanely gorgeous. And I do love the fact that I was able to custom pick the colors to a certain extent because they only have so many that you can choose from. But still, you know, it does have a special place in my heart. But when it comes to card holders, even though I do end up using this, I definitely prefer something that's all leather, something that is a little bit more durable, and something that has more credit card slots as well. When it comes to card holders, I sincerely feel that this is one of the best small leather goods to start a collection. And the reason I say that is because with a wallet, you interact with it daily. So you can really get a feel for the brand. You can really get a feel for the quality before you end up dropping some serious cash on a handbag. But that does it for my video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. And I hope I was able to give you a little bit more information on these pieces, especially if you're looking to add them to your collection. But thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure and give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already and you would like to, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and I'll see you guys later. And as always, make it a fabulous day or not. The choice is yours. Have a great day.